Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. Today we will solve frigate ontogeniness using container manager. And then in later videos, we will integrate it with Home Assistant for automations and notifications. Now I understand not everybody has ontogeniness. So to help you with setup and test ontogeniness before you can make this investment, I have created a video on how you can run Synology DSM 7 on your PC. You should be seeing the link to that video on the top right corner of this video. I'll also leave the link down in the description below if you want to watch that video later. I highly recommend using it only for testing and consider investing in a real Synology NAS for long-term use, especially if you're planning to host your personal critical data on it. You can also install Frigate as an add-on on Home Assistant if you're running it on a bare metal. But I don't recommend using Frigate on Home Assistant if you're running it on a virtualized environment. I have tested this already and it's not very reliable, especially when you are using a USB version of Coral TPU. This is because the pass-through USB connection keeps dropping, so I decided to move my installation on a Docker and use Home Assistant integration for my automations. Alright, so this will be a 3-video series for Frigate where we will be talking about installations, configurations, and the integration of Frigate on Home Assistant. So subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified when I release the next video on this series. So before we start on the tutorial, let's have a brief introduction of Frigate. Frigate is a complete local NVR designed for Home Assistant with AI object detection. It uses OpenCV or TensorFlow to perform real-time object detection locally for IP cameras. It's highly recommended to use Google Coral Accelerator, which can outperform even the best CPUs. I'll be using USB version of Google Coral for this tutorial. I'll leave my affiliate link down in the description below if you want to purchase it. Frigate also has a Home Assistant integration which uses MQTT. You must have installed and set up MQTT already on Home Assistant for this to work. This is only required if you want to integrate Frigate with the Home Assistant. I already made a video about MQTT on Home Assistant. I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. Alright, so let's get started with the tutorial. I'm assuming you have already installed a container manager on your Synology NAS from Package Center and you should have a shared folder called Docker. So go ahead and open Docker share folder and create a new folder in there called Frigate. Inside Frigate, create two more folders and name them config and storage. Also create or upload a new YAML file and name it compose.yaml inside the main Frigate folder. We will be using Docker Compose method to install Frigate. To do that, you can simply copy the configs from Frigate documentation and paste them into newly created compose.yaml file. I'll leave the link to the documentation website down in the description below. Scroll down on the installation page until you see a Docker and simply copy the Docker Compose configuration and paste them into compose.yaml file which we created earlier. You might need to install text editor package from Package Center in your Synology NAS to edit text files. Before we go to next step, let's go through the configuration and update them accordingly as per our setup. First one is your container name. You must run the container with hyperprivileges for this to work. Next line will restart it in case it crashes are your NAS reboots. Then the image which will be downloaded and installed. Then we have a shared memory size or shim. Frigate uses shared memory to store frames during processing. The default is 64 MB, which should be good from two cameras which are detecting as 720p. If you have more cameras or you are detecting at higher resolution, then you'll have to calculate and update your shrimp size accordingly. You should use the formula on the documentation page to calculate your shrimp size. You will be getting warnings in your logs if your shrimp utilization is getting close to what is set in the configs with the recommended size. If frigate setup is exiting with a bus error in the logs, that means you have run out of your shared memory and it's time to calculate and update it. Next, you need to select the device which you are using for image processing. I'm using USB Coral, so I'll leave that line in and then comment out remaining lines. The next one is configuring your volumes. So the first line is just getting the local time, so I'll leave it as is. Next, we need to update our frigate config path. If you're a Docker user, you might know that the left side of the colon belongs to you and the right side belongs to the container. That means we can update or change the left side of the colon according to our setup and it will be passed onto the container. So go back to your Synology NAS and open FireStation. Then go to Docker shared folder and then open frigate folder. Right click on config folder and then go to properties. Copy the location path and paste the location in the compose.html file to set up the config path. Do the same for storage folder. Then we have config for temporary cache. Initial recordings are written here before converting to MP4 and move to recording folder inside the storage folder. Next are the ports. If you're not using any of these mentioned ports already, you can leave them as default. If you want to change any one of these, you can do so by updating the number on the left side of the colon. I'll update the port number 5000 to 9150 since I'm already using port 5000 for my test Synology NAS. Last one is to add a password in case you want to use password template inside the frigate config and pass the password data from this compose.html file. Save the file and close it. So that's all about the Docker Compose file. Before we can run this and start the installation, we need to create and update the frigate config file. Without this file, frigate will not start. So to do so, go to config folder we created earlier inside the frigate folder and create or upload a new file called config.jml. This file is required to start frigate. I'll leave the basic configuration down in the description below and the documentation link for full reference configs so that you can tweak the settings the way you want. We'll discuss these configs in more details in the next video. Copy the configs from the description and paste them into config.jml file. Okay, let's have a quick look at the configuration file. The first setting is for MQTT. It is required if you are integrating frigate with any other system. In my case, I'm integrating it with Home Assistant, so I have added my Home Assistant IP as a host and the username and password which I want to use on Home Assistant side. Next one is regarding detector. Since I'm using USB Coral, so the configs for USB are added here. If you are using the PCIe version or any other detector, you will have to update your configs accordingly. Next one is to add the cameras. For the path, you might have to check the documentation of your camera to get RTSP stream path. For example, in my case, I'm using Java cameras. So I'm accessing the RTSP stream using example URLs as mentioned on the wiki page. It also shows how to test the remote stream on VLC player. I'll leave the link to their wiki page down in the description below. You might need to create a dedicated username and password for the stream, which will be part of the path. Next config is the roles. Roles can be detect or record or both. You can have separate streams for detect and record. For this tutorial, I'm just using the same stream for both. Then you can specify the object you want to track. You can see the list of available objects on the documentation page. Next configs are for snapshots and events. I'll enable them both and set the retaining period config to 5. That means these will be saved for 5 days before frigate starts to override them. I have set the mode to active objects only, as I want Figit to save a snapshot and record a clip only when it detects an active object. There are other modes available too, and we'll discuss about those in our next video, which will be a bit deeper dive into the Figit configuration. We will be adding zones, filter and mask in that video. So stay tuned and subscribe to my channel. Alright, so save the config file and then close it. Now that both the configuration files are updated, we can start the installation process. Go to Container Manager on your Synology NAS and create a new project. Give it a name and set the path to main folder which we created earlier. It should pick up the Docker Compose file automatically and check to use existing Docker Compose file and click OK. You should see all the configurations which you did earlier. Click Next. Ignore the web portal setting and click Next. Check start the project when created and click Done. You should see a download process started. This might take some time. So while Figit is being downloaded and installed, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified every time I release a new video about smart home automation, security and network storage. When the download process completes, the last few lines should talk about network creation and Figit container creation with the exit code 0. This means installation has completed without errors. In the Container Manager, go to Container tab and you should see a Figit container that should be running with a green circle next to it. Wait for it if it is still processing. If it is orange or gray, that means there were some issues during the startup, so head over to logs to see what's happening there. One quick tip here. If you're using Synology Firewall, then you might be getting communication timed out error in your logs from your camera. Then you might have to allow the container IP address in the firewall. To do that, go to Network tab and under Figit Default Bridge, note down the subnet. Now go to Firewall and create a new rule for Figit container by selecting it from the list of applications and entering the subnet and mask under the source IP address. This should allow your Figit container to communicate with your camera. Once the Figit is up and running without any errors, you should be able to access it using your Synology NAS IP followed by the port number you specified earlier. In my case, the port number was 9150, so I'll use this one to access Figit. If you didn't change the port and you're still using default port number, then it should be your NAS IP colon 5000. There you go, the Figit is installed and running on Synology NAS using Docker. That's it for this video. We'll talk more about configuring Figit in next video, where we will be adding zones, masks, and filters. So subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified when next video is released. I'll see you then.